Let us move towards our next bit. It is reflection of light. You are well known about the reflection phenomenon and its rules in 10th standard or its lower. Reflection of light. Very simple. Let us construct suppose PA is an incident ray incident at point A. Suppose PA is an incident ray incident at point A on plane reflecting surface XY. Similarly, I can take another ray which is QC. Because C is, we are using C as notation for velocity of light. It's a small letter. QC, it is an incident ray, incident at point C on plane reflecting surface. And you are well known about this. When a ray incidents on plane reflecting surface like mirror, it reflects in the opposite direction. Draw a normal at point A. Suppose NA, what is NA? NA is the normal drawn at point A on the plane reflecting surface XY. We know about this, that is angle PAN. It is the angle between incident ray and normal, called as angle of incidence. That is angle PAN, that is angle of incidence. And angle NAR, angle NAR, this is the angle between normal and reflected. What is angle of reflection denoted by R? Angle NAR is the angle between reflected ray and normal, called as angle of reflection. Angle NAR.
that is angle of, and we have proved angle of reflection is equal to angle of incidence, or angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. For this, let us draw a perpendicular line AB on incident ray QC at point B. Similarly, draw a perpendicular at point B on reflected ray A. Let's see at the diagram. We have, or according to 9th or 8th standard or 10th standard knowledge, if this angle is I, then this angle is also I. And if this is R, then this angle is also R. According to theory, then see at the diagram, we get the two right angle triangles, that is angle A, B, C, triangle A, B, C, and triangle A, B, C. These two angles, these two triangles are right angle triangle, in which angle B and angle D are right angle. If we are successful in showing these two triangles are congruent, then we can easily prove angle I is equal to angle. But for how? Let us see. This angle is B, angle B is equal to angle D. These two angles are right angle triangles having measure 90 degrees. AC is common thing between two triangles. AC is common, side AC is common. And if light wave reflects from point A to D in time t with velocity c, then AD must be equal to CD. At the same time, the point B travels towards the plane reflecting surface xy, then this distance must be equal to CD. This shows that two sides and one angle, two sides and one angle of two triangles are same, then angle A must be equal to angle C. Using this law, we can prove angle A is equal to angle C, which means that angle A is nothing but angle I and angle C is nothing but angle R, which means that angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. This is the reflection of light on the basis of Huygens principle. There are two or three laws. One is incident ray and reflected ray lying or on opposite side of normal. Similarly, incident ray, normal and reflected ray are in the same plane, lie in the same plane. Also, angle of incidence, just we have proved the angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. These are the three laws related with reflection of light. Students, we have completed this BEAT reflection of light. I hope you will get the, or you have got the knowledge about reflection of light.